Hi, my name is Mingzi Ho, and I'm a Technical Solutions Specialist at Esri Canada. In the next couple of videos, I will be introducing you to ArcGIS Online, what it is, how it could be used as a toolset to do analysis, and then visualizing your findings as an application to share with your audience member. So what is ArcGIS Online? Well, ArcGIS Online is a geospatial cloud platform where you can easily and quickly make maps, collaborate and share these maps with others within a secure and private infrastructure. So think of ArcGIS Online as a big toolbox. You can gather and store your data in this toolbox. What's neat about it is that this platform has endless amount of tools for you to explore your data set visually, whether it is a map or a table or a chart. Now, when you are ready, there are many templates you can choose from within the platform that takes you through step-by-step on creating web application, which then can be shared to the public. Now, we'll be doing just that in the next couple of videos. There are going to be a total of 10 videos, all around 10 to 15 minutes long, and these videos will guide you step-by-step on performing a particular task. Now, the webpage we are looking at right now is what we call a story map, and you'll be provided with the URL so you can preview the steps and access any additional resources that were not covered in the video. In the first video, which is this video, we are going to familiarize ourselves with the ArcGIS Online platform. In the second video, we are going to download some open data and bring it into a map document. After that, we're going to add some context to the data we bring in and make it more valuable. We'll learn how to add additional data and run some analysis in video 5. Next, we'll bring in some point data and learn how to configure pop-ups for our data and explore other analysis tools. Finally, in video 9 and 10, we are going to learn how to share our findings and map using ArcGIS Instant Apps and ArcGIS Story Maps. So it's going to be a jam-packed session, and I am just skimming the surface in terms of the capabilities of ArcGIS Online. So with housekeeping out of the way, let's take a look at ArcGIS Online. First, we need to sign into ArcGIS Online, so let's go ahead and do that. With the credential we are given, I'm going to sign in. And what most likely you'll end up is in the home page, actually. And this is a pretty self-explanatory page. Clearly not much is happening here. Next, you have a gallery page, and this is where you can view what other have done on ArcGIS Online. So let's hop on to the group section here. This is where you create space to collaborate with other ArcGIS Online user. What is collaboration like? Well, it's kind of like sharing the same data set, using the same map and editing the same map. And all this can be done by creating a group and adding the people needed. The next tab we'll talk about is organization. So organization page is just a summary of your account, what you can use, what you can't use, how many credits are left, as well as who your administrator is. So you can't see it here because I'm the administrator of my own account, but majority of you guys may have an administrator that you can contact if you have any questions. Now you'll notice that I didn't go by orders in terms of the header up top because I just introduced you to some of the pages that are there, but not necessarily as important as what we'll be doing with these videos. So let's get into the more important tabs. So this here is the content page. And in the content page is where you can manage all your files like maps, data, applications that you might build. You can create folders. Right now, your account will look pretty empty, but once you get started, I highly recommend organizing your files to a particular folder. In the content page, you can change the share settings of your items. As a default, everything you upload or create is shared with only yourself and requires you to personally change that setting to be shared to the greater public. Now you can add items as well, whether it's uploading your own file or creating something new. The next tab is one of my new favorite tabs. It's called Notebook. And this is where if you are a programmer and you're comfortable with programming in Python and doing some data manipulation, this is a tab just for you where you can create notebooks using Jupyter Notebooks and create a bunch of different script and programming to kind of modify your data and get it ready for mapping. So there is that option if you are comfortable with programming. Now, the next two tabs we're going to talk about are the Scene and Map tab. And this is where all the mapping happens. So in the Scene tab here, it'll bring you to kind of a 3D previewer of your map. So this is mapping in 3D. I'm not going to cover this during this these next couple of videos, but just know that you can create 3D maps on the web, on the cloud, and there is that option for you to do that. Now jumping to the final tab, we can go in here, home, go and click on map. This is what we call the map viewer, where we'll be doing majority of the mapping. Currently, ArcGIS Online is in the process of updating the interface, so there are going to be two map viewer we'll be using. This is the map viewer, and to access the map viewer classic, which is the older one, you can click on open in map viewer classic. I opened it in a new tab. So this is what the old map viewer looks like. So a big difference, but the tool sets, some of them are still there and some of them are not there yet. So we'll be going over that during the next couple of videos. So going back to my content page right here, let's explore the other buttons. So this is the search bar where you can search through your files or even search through the entire ArcGIS Online publicly available data. So this is actually very helpful to find a spatial data set that you might need for your mapping. This here is the bell, which is here to notify if you have any notifications. So right now there isn't any, but let's say my colleague invite me to collaborate with them. This will be where it's at. So you can accept or decline their invitation here. Beside the notification is the app drawer. This is the app full of drawers you can use. So it's not just, you know, creating a map. We are able to create a lot of different applications like dashboards, web app builder, story maps, which we'll cover, and utilize some of the field survey tools too. But we won't be covering that in this video, but this is where you can find all the different applications. And who knows, if you have some free time, play around with them. Lastly, I want to leave you guys with a task, which is the icon here. So let's give it some flair. So right now I have nothing as in terms of my profile. I have my other resources that I can go into. So if you have any questions about training or have a question that you want to ask just online, you can click it through the shortcuts here. What I'm interested in is my profile. So I'm going to go there. And this is the item gallery that shows all the items I've created using this profile. You can give it an image. So I'm going to put my photo up, let that load, readjust it. And this is simply for people to see that what my face looks like and who is the user behind creating all these map and data set. Because this is the kind of page that people stumble upon when they find a particular map or application you built. And what you'll need to do is actually change your profile to make it public for everyone. Give it a little bio. Hi, I work for Esri Canada as a technical solution specialist. Hit save. And now all the publicly shared items will be available for people outside my group. Go ahead and edit your profile. So until next video, happy mapping!